bitch, I sold out a show. Gonna like a pot on the stove. Yeah, like AP on all of my. I like when that wet on the toes. Picture me riding around in that rose. I put some ice on my wrist, it was woes. Then I ain't got time with you. All of these my body, I got been somebody keep checking my pose. Walk in the club with no warning, take care of the money. They swing on the. Water on me like the sunny, I shine when it's sunny, this platinum and rose. Gonna out the street when I go to DC, I'ma see the mo.
Every time I go on, I get a no-do. Tryna leave me long, no-do. I'm like, baby, I know I'm wrong, but this just how life goes. And I know they'd be happy if I let you.
The NFL on EA Sports has come to the Twin Cities at U.S. Bank Stadium in downtown Minneapolis. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for ball, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the New England Patriots. Play fake here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack.
All right, partner, I'm going to be Captain Obvious right here. Not the start you're looking for offensively, right? Incomplete pass, followed by a sack.
And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline. Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. Now Cousins. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Give him 30 yards there.
I know they had good coverage downfield, but you have to wonder, on third and long like that, how does that happen that they can get that far downfield and complete a pass? You got to guard the sticks, understand where you are, so it's almost like someone fell asleep at the switch, and now that the play's been completed, they've got to dust themselves off on defense, pick it up, and figure out how to not let that happen again.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. So first and 10 now from the 30. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And the movement there coming from the line.
Understand, he wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
They will come up on a first and 5 following the encroachment penalty. Working out of the gun, Cousins. And now he'll tuck it and run. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
They go play action here on first down. They'll buy some time right. And the Vikings are in for the touchdown. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
Extra point up and good by Bailey. And that makes the score 7-0. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Brady and the Patriots now first and 10 at the 20. They'll run it here. This is James White. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That burst, good for 20 and a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to run.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. The Patriots into the red zone for the first time. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get to him quickly here as he stops right around the 13. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call run fits, one was in the right place.
The throw on second down by Brady is incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be 4th down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. Do you like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A first down throw for Cousins. Trying to lay one up deep. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And this, they managed to get it done.
Line of scrimmage. Again, the 25, second and 10. On second down, Cook. And he'll go dead right at the 30-yard line.
They need to make up some ground, and they did.
Cousins from the gun on third. Steps away to his left. He may try and run for this. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a in out there and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
On first and 10, Cousins. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Here's Cousins. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Third and long for Cousins. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
On now to kick it away is the punter, Matt Weil. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing.
Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith. Gronkowski, the intended receiver.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Following the interception, Cousins stepping up. He'll try and run. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Hey, Ringo, 48.
Cousins on first down. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13. Now Cousins. He'll find Thielen working the middle. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. The Vikings on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Dan Bailey now for the field goal try. And Bailey able to knock it through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, partner.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was a nice field.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level. You hit them, they go through.
And now out come the Patriots. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
Cousins now. And this one pulled in by Rudolph. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. And Bailey able to knock it through. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. An abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three. Bailey now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that wood, he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this you're going to do that?
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
He hits White, complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I'm guessing, partner, that if we're in the huddle with the Patriots right now, there's not a single guy that thinks they have any chance of coming back in this one, especially not with Tom Brady.
Yeah, who's Tom Brady? What's he done in the past as far as comebacks are concerned? Yeah, down right now, but that can evaporate quickly with him in the huddle. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now a carry for White. And past the 30, down to about the 27. 9 yards of pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more of a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
What an advantage having an elite guy in the middle of the defensive line, because not only does he take up the space and let the linebackers run free, they can also make plays himself, as we just saw there.
And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. Play action. Now it's Brady. And this is caught. It's Edelman. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A good pickup there, a 22. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues as a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman, a yard touchdown grab, and the Patriots are back within a score. On those slants, everything happens.
Inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass. Got inside for the catch and the score. Goskowski now out to kick it away.
A And that coach is insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They've got good starting field position to come up here first and 10. Cousins. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Listen to me.
Throwing again, Cousins on second and 10. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Morgan. And he gets this deep into Patriot territory. It's a big one there for the Vikings. 42 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like you and I both know, it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Final minute now of the third quarter. Cousins to throw it this time. Forced out to his left. And he's taken down. Trying to do a little too much. Getting outside of the pocket. And it results in a sack.
That's his second sack of the game. And the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive linemen across from them. What moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
To throw his Cousins. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that set up a first and goal. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They come up in a two tight end look here. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
From back at the 4, here's second and goal. Now this time he'll look to throw. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. A great play there from 4 yards out. And the Vikings are going to add on their lead. Bailey ought to kick this one away. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now Brady gets away with one. Lucky, could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him, though. Find him. Find him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Looking deep downfield. He's got a man complete. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is an...
And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45. Gronkowski, the intended target.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
First, first. Hey, 382,
last 50. First down, here's Cousins. Throwing one incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From the gun, here's Cousins. And he comes back with one complete. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
All right, now here we go.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. First down, here's the run with Cook. Finding room to the 20 and down to the 16-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
The good old toss play, and this time they go to the left side, so give a lot of credit to the offensive line. Center, guard, tackle, able to seal that side, but the guy that we don't give enough credit to, wide receivers. They have to do a great job of blocking downfield, otherwise that play can be spilled in the backfield. In this case, everyone handled their responsibilities, and they picked up really nice yardage.
Oh, a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Working out of the gun, Cousins. And complete, right side, the tight end Rudolph. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Now, this is a big down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Cousins to throw it. And he's got Kyle